Hello friends, welcome back to a new video. This is third video in the series of videos where I am discussing about books. In previous two videos, we discussed about the books to refer for GIB and CIB respectively. So if you missed those videos, then you can check out from the link below. Friends, most often I am asked about the books that every Indian banker should read to become a smart and knowledgeable banker. Especially when you are new to banking or you are from science background. These days, mostly B.Techs or science graduates are landing in banks and they find it very tough in their initial years of bank. So if you are an ambitious banker and looking to move beyond normal debit and credit or F4 F10, as we often make fun in banks, which has Finacle as their CBS platform, then friends, this video is definitely for you. But if you are a normal debit credit or F4 F10 person and want to retire doing this only, then you can skip this video and move ahead. Friends, my personal advice is to stick till last of this video as you will definitely take some positives out of this video. Friends, the best thing I like about being a banker is that we need to update ourselves regularly. The rules or norms that existed 10 years back may not work today. So as a banker, you need to keep yourself updated. And that's what a smart banker is all about. In India, people look at bankers as best advisors. If you go to any social gathering, most often people around you end up taking advices about how to manage their finances. I have personally experienced this and you will also experience this throughout your banking career. Since officers are transferred quite often, I got the opportunity to stay at many places away from home and most often on rentals. Wherever I stayed, I experienced landlords or people around usually approach for their queries, be it regarding education loan of their children or regarding housing loans or where to invest their funds. So this is the reputation of a banker in society. In this video, I will share some books which I highly recommend that you also read and become knowledgeable and smart banker. These books will help you in various stages of your career. I will discuss these in order of their preference. So let's start. The first book which every banker must read at least once is Dare to Lead: The Transformation of Bank of Baroda. Now, this is the first book which every ambitious banker must have. This is written by Mr. Anil K. Khandelwal, who is former CEO of Bank of Baroda. He is often regarded as the man who changed the Bank of Baroda, and under his leadership, bank attained new heights. Normally, I don't read biographies, but this was my first biography and I thoroughly enjoyed it. I was a new banker when this book was released and every chapter gave a new insight into banking. Being a banker, I could instantly connect with this book. Having served at various positions in the bank, Mr. Khandelwal presented various issues and how he handled them and what tactics he used to manage difficult situations is quite amazing. Friends, when you are working in a public sector or even private sector bank, then you will most often face difficulties that are not in your control. Say for example, demonetization. We as a banker faced many problems from currency management to crowd management. These were beyond our control. But this book presents you how to handle situations that are beyond your control. Mr. Khandelwal handled many such situations during his tenure at the bank. And this book presents great insights. In short, I could say is, if you want to be in banking sector and want to become master at handling internal problems, then this book is your holy manual. The link for this book and all the books in this video can be checked in description. Next book which is must in a banker's kit is Romancing the Balance Sheet by Anil Lamba. Friends, if you are from non-finance background, then indeed this book will make you romancing the balance sheets. Now, balance sheet is one topic many new age bankers run away. Reason is there is no one to teach them how to analyze the balance sheets. And when they receive any balance sheet for analysis, when posted as branch in charge or credit manager, then it's very hard for them to analyze that balance sheet. Most balance sheets these days brought by the customers are ready-made provided by the CAs. So when you do the inspection at unit of the party, then it's hard work for many bankers to make a rough estimate about the figures given in the balance sheet that was provided by the party. In this book, all concepts are explained in a very lucid way. It simply changes your way of looking towards financial transactions. This book is even a must for middle-level and top-level bankers. This book will make you look at balance sheets more practically. This is not just about balance sheet, but it explains in detail how to manage your cash flows and also importance of current assets and liabilities. Apart from that, this book will teach you to estimate how healthy is a firm financially from a banker's point of view. It is a must read for any banker who is shying away saying that they don't understand balance sheets. This book will prove you wrong in multiple ways. Every banker should at least read this book once. This book is also available in Hindi. I have provided both the links which you can check in the description. Next book that I would like to discuss is Banking Case Studies and Rationale. Friends, this book contains 300 plus case studies related to every field of banking. This book is must for every banker who wants to get answer to many of their day-to-day queries. Most often you face with many issues like deceased claims, locker operation rules, account operation rules and many other issues. And because of confusion, you call your regional office and unfortunately from there also you don't get a satisfactory reply. Friends, there is lack of knowledge these days at every level of bank. That's because of mass retirements that took place in recent years. There are probationary officers sitting at many important positions, from HR to advances. Thus, this book will give you many practical case studies which you will encounter in your day-to-day banking. This book will make you self-sufficient in dealing such situations and also increase your reputation in your banking circle. Next book in our list is The Credit Appraisal, Risk Analysis and Decision Making by D.D. Mukherjee. Now this is another must-have for all bankers. This book will make you master in the field of credit analysis and advances. Though this book is very comprehensive and deals with all major points, but one thing I like about this book is the coverage of window dressing techniques. Now as branch head, the sword of targets is always on your head. So if you know how to achieve your targets well, then you are indeed blue-eyed boy of your management or boss. And especially if you can do window dressing and that too ethically. So I learned this a lot from this book. This book in fact filled gaps in my banking. And this is top recommendation from my side. Next book is The Credit Monitoring, Legal Aspect and Recovery of Bank Loan by D.D. Mukherjee. This is another book I highly recommend for every banker. And this is in fact sequel to previous book. In this book, all practical aspects and legal aspects are covered in simple and lucid manner. This book will be helpful in your day-to-day job and decision-making process. Yes, friends, as a credit officer, you should have very good decision-making ability. Else you end up making wrong decisions and then face the music of audit teams and higher authorities. With many practical case studies included, you can master post-lending process easily and understand the legal aspects well. As I said before, you can check link to this book in the description of this video. Sixth book in my list of must-haves is The Credit Appraisal and Analysis of Financial Statements, A Handbook for Bankers and Finance Managers by R.K. Gupta and Himanshu Gupta. Now friends, this is another book that is must in your banking kit. This was in fact first book for bankers and credit managers on credit appraisal with analysis of financial statements. And that too in very simple language covering various problems faced by bank officers of almost all banks. Friends, as per recent RBI survey, mounting NPAs and disciplinary actions in the banks are reported to be result of weak appraisal. And as I said before, weak appraisal is because there are hardly any mentors in the bank. This book has covered all major aspects to understand logically with all ins and out of appraisal along with financial statements. This book is indeed holy manual for all officers who are working in bank but have no background of banking terms and its technical aspects with logical understanding besides being finance officers. Next book in our list is Wipers in the Bushes and a Banker's Ordeals, A Credit Manager's Handbook by V. Narayanan. Now, friends, this is one book which I highly recommend for all bankers. Friends, when you sit for the first time in credit, then you have a fair insight. Working in advances, you need a mentor. And if you got that mentor, then you are blessed. But these days, with fast promotions and lack of knowledgeable persons at both branch, regional and head office levels, sometimes new bankers working in credit or advances commit grave mistakes. I was fortunate to have a role model during my initial years in Bank of India. He was in later stages of his banking career and I learned a lot of fundas from this particular manager. Unfortunately, he is no more in this world now, but the teachings he gave me indeed proved beneficial later in my career when I become branch in charge. Now, this book is for all those bankers who need a mentor in credit, and Mr. Narayanan has written a perfect book. This book becomes even must when you are taking promotions. Indeed, this is a fantastic book and must for all branch heads for doing credit, especially the young generation without experience of dealing in credit proposals. This book will take out the fear inside you. The book is written in very simple English and is easily understandable, and you can correlate with various cases mentioned in the book. Eighth book in our list is Hands on Credit, Doing It Yourself by D.D. Mukherjee. This is another good book of learning credit. The best part of this book is it's more like a workbook rather than a theoretical read. Being a banker, you must understand the credit process and know how to apply the concepts practically. This book gives you that only. But note that you must have some basic knowledge about credit before you start this book. Next book in our list is Banker's Handbook on Kisan Credit Card. Now friends, in rural banking, KCC is one product which constitutes major credit portfolio of every branch. And with rural tenure now being made compulsory, it is must to have sufficient knowledge about KCC. Also, in scale 2, get ready to handle rural branches. And thus, you should know about KCC from initial inspection stage to post-sanctioning follow-up phase. This book will give you great insights about how to handle every stage of KCC. So, if you are an officer working in rural branch or agriculture field officer or a branch head, then this book is must in your collection. No bank's master circular gives guidelines on different stages of KCC. Each circular just points out the framework which the credit officer has to follow. But this book will guide you the exact intricacies related to KCC. As always, link for this important book is also in description. Do check out. Next book in our list is Managers Who Make a Difference by T.V. Rao. Friends, as a banker and with long career ahead, you will become manager after few years. With most banks expanding and with shortage of staff, you can expect to become manager in very short time. I was also handed over charge of a rural branch during my probation itself. So don't think that you need to get promoted to scale 2 to get charge of a branch. Even scale 1 are being given charge of small branches. So friends, it's better you prepare yourself well before you are given responsibilities. Better be prepared well in advance. This book will guide you how to groom yourself to become a better manager. This book is full of case studies and will train you, or in fact groom you, towards your future. Your future will not stop just at JIB or CIB. Your management or zonal offices are watching you. And if they saw capabilities in you, then they will definitely give you a role of major responsibility. Had this book released earlier when I was given the charge of branch, I would have benefited a lot. But you all are blessed that this book full of case studies is around you and you can learn and groom yourself to become better future managers. Let's move ahead with our list. Next book is Balance Sheet Decoded. Now friends, this is another book on balance sheet which you can refer. As a banker, you can't hide away from balance sheets if you need to grow in bank. This book is full of practical case studies and this will make you learn the concepts really well. You can check out link for this book in description. Note that friends, the links are updated from time to time and will always contain latest updated editions only. Next book which I would like to advise to all bankers is Day-to-Day Economics. Now friends, banking is full of economics and its applications. But a layman and especially bankers from non-commerce background don't understand the complex theories and explanations. But this book, written by Satish Bhai Deodhar, explains difficult economic terms in a very simple and easy manner. I never read any other book as quick and as interesting as this. Every banker should read this book at least once. In fact, my learning of economics started with this book only. The book has very nicely elaborated the concept of economy. This helps in understanding economics in our day-to-day life. This also makes you understand the policies adopted by RBI to counter the crisis situation in our country. The book gives insights of world economy with several examples that occurred in recent past. You will also learn the factors behind the success of nations like Japan and the reform action adopted by different countries from time to time to develop their economy and improving life of people. The link of this book is also in description. Do check out this bestseller book from IIMA Professor. Next book is I Do What I Do by Raghuram Rajan. Friends, this is an amazing book which puts you into the shoes of an RBI governor. This book is very simple and you will understand basic working style of RBI and economic policies which are required for our country. Friends, if you ask anyone in banking or finance space about who is their most favorite RBI governor, then most will take one name only, that is of Mr. Raghuram Rajan. Now he understands economy so well, and by reading this book, you will have great insights about working of this great gem. Moreover, you as a banker will come to know various intricacies related to running the economic policies. Most often, we as a banker raise many questions regarding some policy frameworks of RBI. But when you read this book, you will come to know the exact reasons why such policies are made. Apart from that, you will also learn where you should take the stand against the top management, as Mr. Rajan was known for many tough decisions which he took against the ruling governments. So go for this book from the superstar of our economy. Now there is Hindi version also available of this book. So those who are comfortable with Hindi can go for that book also. Links of both the versions are given in description. Next book in our list is Finance Made Easy series. Friends, this is basically a combo of four books. First is How to Read Profit and Loss Statement. Second is How to Analyze a Financial Statement. Then third is How to Read a Balance Sheet. And lastly, How to Read a Cash Flow Statement. Friend, good thing about this combo pack is that all the points have been explained through case studies only. These books came as a savior for me when I joined the bank. I was so confused with all this financial stuff and was not getting easy answers. But these books presented all the concepts in very easy fashion. Also, since books are very short, you can finish one book in one day only. Moreover, the topics are presented in very easy fashion. Next book is by Napoleon Hill, that is Think and Grow Rich. Now friends, I will share three books that are offbeat, but as a banker, you must read it from time to time. Friends, some books never get old, and this is one such book. I read this book every year. This book keeps me in right frame of mind. I like this book so much that I also have audiobook of this also. I often listen to this book when traveling. This book teaches you techniques that can help you to do better almost anything in your life. It's not just about making you rich or wealthy, but this book will teach you how to achieve your goals practically. Friends, thousands of people have benefited from this book. With price of this book at just around 70 at the time of publishing this video, this book is must for any person, be it banker or from any other profession. In fact, I have gifted this book to almost 30-40 people in my family and friend circle. Friends, being a banker, you will most often face criticism from every corners. So when you face criticism in your life, try to turn pages in this book and you will definitely find way to cope and move on. And that's the basic reason I read or listen this book every year. This book will help you to make your dreams come true. Otherwise, those dreams will always be in your wish list. I have also posted the Hindi edition link in the description. So those who want to read in Hindi can get that edition. Next book which is in our list is The Power of Our Subconscious Mind by Joseph Murphy. Friends, this is another classic book. Millions of editions of this book have been sold worldwide and has changed life of many people. Friends, being a banker, you need to understand customer psychology, and before knowing that, you need to understand your mind itself. This book will make you realize the true potential of your subconscious mind. This mind makes you achieve great things, which in fact your active mind can't even think of. So, as we force any idea into our mind, we involuntarily start working towards it with our greatest capability, using our full potential, and thus we achieve what seemed initially impossible to us. Though this book is not a banking or finance book, but this is again recommended for all bankers. Both English and Hindi edition links are provided in description. Friends, finally, I have come to the last book which I will recommend to all my bankers friends. That is How to Win Friends and Influence People, written by Dale Carnegie. This is another non-banking book I highly recommend to all bankers. This book also have changed life of millions of people around the world. Now, you should know why you should read this book. Friends, being a banker, you are in a social job. You are always surrounded by people. This book will make you learn how to accept people as they are, whether or not you like some people, be it your customers or colleagues at bank. Friends, being a banker, it's not all about banking. One major aspect of banking is how to deal with people around you, and especially how to influence your prospective customers. Just imagine there is a government servant who is retiring this month, and you know he will receive his retirement dues shortly. So as a banker, how will you approach or influence this prospective customer to come at your branch with such huge deposit? I learned a lot from this book, and so will you. So friends, with this I wind up this video. All the books mentioned in this video are best suited for Indian bankers only. So if you are from outside India, then these books may not be that beneficial to you. But for Indian bankers, these are must. And after going through these books, and if you are science or arts graduate or even commerce graduate, then this will transform you into a smart banker. So when you talk in front of seniors or customers, you won't have any fear. And thus you will become a fearless banker. So friends, if you get these books or read books that are mentioned in this video, then you won't have any fear ever in your banking career. Friends, I understand you can't finish all these books quickly, but yes, at least you can make a start. Start with most basic ones and then move on to higher books. Get the books which are must at this point of your career, and then slowly you can finish other books also. Another point I would like to make is that we will always update the description of this video so that if we feel that you need any other book also, then that book will be added in the list. Another thing is, banks these days are lacking mentors. And these books are nothing less than mentors for new age bankers. Lastly, just subscribe to the channel and share these videos wherever possible. As I always believe in giving quality stuff to all my fellow bankers. Thank you and happy learning.